Hello,
and welcome to AWS This Week. This week, I thought I'd decide to invite everyone in my company to get some face-to-camera time. Scott and I don't want to hog the camera the whole lockdown. These are the Cloud Gurus, who in no particular order keep this company running. I invited them here about 10 minutes ago, so I'd like to thank them for joining. Now on to AWS This Week. This week, AWS OpsHub for Snow Family is introduced. Elastic Beanstalk gets an update. The AWS blog tracks COVID-19 initiatives, and we announce our Guru of the Week. It's AWS This Week with me, Nick Triantafilou, and a whole bunch of Cloud Gurus. First up this week, we have AWS OpsHub for Snow Family, a new tool AWS have released for you to manage your Snowball devices. AWS OpsHub takes all the existing operations in the Snowball API and presents them as a simple graphical interface. Prior to this, Snowball devices were managed via command line interface or by using REST APIs. So this is a huge improvement. And one thing to note here, this isn't a part of the AWS console. It's a separate application you install locally on Mac or Windows to manage your Snow Family devices. This means it doesn't require an internet connection to use either, which is a great feature if you're trying to manage something in a data center and don't have Wi-Fi. And I'll also sneak one more announcement into this section. With this release, AWS also announced that Snowball Edge Storage Optimized now delivers 25% faster data transfer performance at no additional cost, which is awesome. Great job, Snowball team. Next, Elastic Beanstalk has a brand new console, which is now generally available. If you've never used Elastic Beanstalk, it's a fantastic way to deploy code in an environment that you don't have to manage. You simply upload a zip file and it automatically handles the deployment, capacity provisioning, load balancing, scaling, and health monitoring all for you by itself. It's perfect for developers who just want to develop and test their code without worrying about infrastructure. The Beanstalk console was a little dated, so this is a welcome release from the Beanstalk team, bringing it in line with all the AWS services that you are familiar with. Now, not a release as such, but AWS have both a Day One blog and a page dedicated to the AWS initiatives and responses to COVID-19. There are loads of articles available covering topics like empowering education with critical infrastructure for remote learning and work, information about support for AWS certification candidates, and so on. There's a few links in the resources section, so be sure to have a look. Okay, time for our Guru of the Week. This week, our winner is Luis Guevara from Peru. Congratulations, a t-shirt, sticker, and hand side card are on their way to you, and you're also in the draw to win a free ticket to reInvent in 2020. If you'd like to win Guru of the Week, be sure to check out this week's question of the week on our forum link below. All right, that's all from me this week.
Keeping us to awesome,
and we'll see you next time.